Hello guys, this is Life Issue, this is Blessing. Thank you so much for coming to our channel today. Now, if you've not subscribed to our YouTube channel, please help hit the button, go to our channel, help support us, help subscribe to our channel so that we can grow. Thank you so much for all the support. All right, so today I'm going to be bringing to you this story that happened somewhere in Italy. Now, if you've not seen this viral video, I will be showing you the video for you to learn about relationships, okay? Now, I'm going to give you a background information. This video was taken by a passerby, and it was between a boy and a girl fighting. So, somewhere in Italy, okay? So, what I want you to do is for you to sit down and watch this video, and then I will come and talk about it. Oh dear. I'm just trying to play the video. Uh-oh, where's my video?
See what the woman get belly. See with the husband, you know, they disgrace yourself. Nigeria people when they not get shame. You know, you said those yourself for herself. Sister, what did they happen now? Now for set all this thing for house now. Sister, what did they happen? No, I'm not video. I don't have to do that. They happen now.
You don't mean to make everybody work.
I'm not video now.
Before you come out, you fuck her or you not fuck her.
Yes, I'm all. You fuck Nebri, not fuck me. You fuck Nebri.
Who don't get the belly?
Now give me belly.
See.
Now give me belly.
When I travel.
Ask me.
When I travel. I travel, go motor, I go work. When I talk,
Okay.
My friend called to call me, say, there is someone on that man for house. Now, 9 months I spent for there. How many months did you take?
This
belly
day? This belly day, 8 months. I don't be 9 months.
Okay, now your belly.
When you come out?
This, now you fucker.
Now 7 months, now you get there, that be 9 months.
Now you fucker, you fucker or you not fucker?
Now 9 months, which kind of 9 months?
Okay, now my friend,
which kind of 9 months?
You not fucker? Yeah, you teach and now you
do. Oh, why do they go?
Because I don't buy motor.
Huh?
I don't buy motor.
Go, go, go. Where you stand for? This day
I
stand for.
I don't get there.
When
now
you come
to my house, you go. Now my house, you go.
I beg. See how they disgrace yourself. Another man, Belé.
Now you give me Belé.
Shut up.
Now you give me the Belé.
Another man.
People say she dey, you told me, you not concern me. Now she give me the Belé. Now you give me the Belé.
Another man picking, now you want give me. That's what they do for Europe.
Now you sleep.
Europe guests. Now Europe guests. That's what they do.
I don't blame you.
Another man picking, now she want give me.
You deny the Belé. You deny the Belé.
See this one, you don't know yourself. You probably the you get man they talk to me in here.
Okay, you fuck her, you not fuck her.
You fuck her, you not fuck.
Now you get picky. You can't carry your responsibility.
Give me a motor key. Give me a motor key.
Who's not gonna give you? You not gonna collect
the key. With me.
Give me a tar key.
Collect the key.
I don't for months.
Give me a tar key.
Now give her that key. Now you give me the belle.
Tell your family give me a tar key.
You not gonna give you that tar key. Why you tell me say
when I never buy motor? When I never buy motor? When are they
suffer? Forget motor. Now my house.
That's what they do.
Now my house.
Once they go Europe, they see say the border they better, then they progress. And after they carry people belly.
I didn't suffer. I didn't wait. When you come, when you come. They tell me, hey, my God, remove the belly. Now I go to move 7 months belly.
That's my key.
Now I go to move 7 months. Okay, why you not be like? Why you show my
people
go to move?
People they call me. I didn't see your wife with another man.
Now you keep this man for me.
Yeah, see your wife.
Why you come and you see man for my house? Now you come, you see my
wife. That trouser when I see that one.
Who's trouser?
Yeah. I see one trouser.
Who
get this trouser? Who get these bossers? What do you talk?
Which bossers?
You know, you say now me get me. I don't know what thing I buy. I see trouser, I see bossers. We say I'm in my house. Don't make any belly.
Ask when that house that you rent. Now, since when you come out, now stop at the
same time. Give my tar key, madam.
Okay, I'm not going to give you tar key.
Give my tar key.
I'm not going to give you any tar key. Carry your responsibility. When you never anything, now this girl now she come for you. Now she dey help you. Now your leg don't better. She don't change your leg.
Make call police.
You don't get mad.
You were the witness. So if police come, you.
Now you give me the belle.
Carry your responsibility.
Make call police.
Now you give me the belle.
Carry your responsibility.
How you give me belle?
Why you think that I go take care of this baby?
But now come on, your man will slap you.
Oga, try ya. Carry your responsibility.
You give me belle. You don't say.
Now go remove the baby.
Now go remove the baby.
Now the mother of your baby. He carry your baby. Now go. Where you see say now you go?
I don't know why they did that.
There's a man coming, you don't go to PL test. You say you know they do.
When I call police.
You know they do the PL test. But you set up your belly. Now you get them. You go to the PL test.
Make police come.
I got a belly. Don't walk up on you.
Give me a copy.
Okay, now they give you.
No.
You go and
blow you. I will blow you.
Carry your responsibility. You be mad. Are you not a man, no?
Love with belly now.
Oh, that's my picking.
Okay, you know what? How dear? All right, let's talk about this story. But when I saw this video, I was like, no, I have to do this because there's a lot of things that we can learn from this video. And first of all, let me say this. Someone, because I'm going to be looking at people's comments on some website that I went to. Now, somebody was asking, is this Europe? Or it looks like Jack on the Estate. Yeah, Italy really looks like Nigeria. If you've ever been to Italy, there's some parts of Italy that you actually think you're in Nigeria. So the way they build their house, the way they structure, their roads are not as neat as, UK. I'm not even talking about America, because there's some part of America that is not as good as we think. So this is Italy, and as you can see, he was speaking Italian. Was when he was trying to get the police. So let's talk about this story. I know you guys have watched the video, but let's talk about this story. So I'm going to use someone's comments to address what happened here. So I'm going to read this. Why this same pattern with hustling Nigerian ladies and men? I see this kind of issues in Ghana too. When the lady keeps you in her house and is hustling, the time you know reason say she no be Europe girls. God has blessed you and you now know she engages different man. Please stop this wickedness. If a woman is there for you while you are down, compensate her when you have. Dear woman, focus on your hustle, please. Stop taking care of men. Most will not give a fuck when God bless them. Okay, so that's a comment that I got from somebody's wall. And I want to talk about what happens in Western world sometimes with Nigerians. So you meet a girl an African girl in Western world, kind of like develop interest, but because of the fact that the way the structure is, the way the country is made, you need two people living together to share responsibility. So what happens is that most Nigerian or African men, they will have a girlfriend and they have a live-in lover. Now, because the girl doesn't want to pay the rent on her own, the guy doesn't want to pay the rent on his own, they get a rent together. So that's for them to share, and they're living together. Now, you can see what the friend was saying. Like, no, but you fuck him. Did you fuck him? The point is, you are sleeping with her. You are doing this without condom. What were you expecting for her not to get pregnant? Now, if you know you don't want to marry a girl, if you know you're not ready to marry a girl, why promise her? Why call her my wife, your wife? Now, the guy was making reference that the friends were saying, come and see what your wife was doing. So, in quotes, this girl has been given this perception that she is about to be, you know, when you're in a relationship and you're relaxed and you're thinking that, okay, this is going to be leading to marriage, okay? Don't promise, don't have a relationship if you know you're not intending to marry this girl. Or marry the girl. Don't allow people to call the girl my wife, your wife, our wife. It is wrong. You are actually blocking her way. See, I talk about karma a lot because I do believe in karma. It is not okay for a man to stop a woman progressing, to stop a woman moving on with her life. You are living in her house. She's actually cooking for you, passing the food, calling you my husband, but in your mind, you don't want to marry her. It is not right. Think about it. If it's your own child, will you like it? Okay, let's talk about the woman's aspect of things. Why will you get pregnant without a man's consent? Did the man tell you you should get pregnant? Did you guys have an agreement that you should get pregnant? Let me tell you, I do believe that if you go to a particular age and you are not married, if you want to have a baby, go ahead and have a baby if you live in the Western world. You're not in Nigeria where they kind of like point finger at you or accuse you of, you know, doing one taboo because you have a child. But because the system helps single mothers, if you get to like 35, 40 and you're not married, please, please, please have your baby. I believe in that, okay? Now, but for you to now get pregnant and the man is not interested, you know what? Make up your mind, I'm going to have my child, with or without him. It doesn't matter. Let me tell you, I don't believe that you must have a man to raise up your child. If you, as a woman, you decided to get pregnant without his consent, from where he's sounding, he wasn't aware. You did not have an agreement. You know, some men, remember that this is a different case altogether. When a man is telling you to get pregnant, you must get pregnant before we marry. Or my mom says you must, you know, some men are so dubious. They don't want to marry you. They are not interested in marrying you. They will give excuses or tell you, like, okay, but get pregnant first now. Or let's be trying for a baby. If you decide you want to fall for that, that's fine. I'm not, you know, but the point is, in this particular case, this guy, from what we can hear, did not promise her or make her or tell her to do that. She got pregnant. Now, I know some of you are wondering, how come he wasn't around for 9 months or 8 months? The point is that in the Western world, some people hustle. Some people actually leave their home, go to a location, work for like 1 year and come back, go another location, so they're not actually at home. People hustle, do a lot of things. Some of them are even drug pushers. I don't know what he's doing, but people do odd jobs or any job just to get by. So this man left this woman for like 8 or 9 months, and then he came back, and the woman is pregnant. I understand how he feels. Let's be frank. The first thing that will come into your mind is this can't be my baby. I was not aware that you are pregnant. Or did she even call him to tell? Even if she told him, the guy does have the right to doubt it because he wasn't around. And now, when you talk about friends that make up stories or talk about things, we don't know. So I get his point. I get where he's coming from. I wasn't around. This baby is 9 months, like you told me, though the woman is saying is 8 months. We get his fear. Now, what I don't understand is, why is he not willing to go for the DNA? Because we know that in the Western world, yeah, DNA can be done even while the woman is pregnant, like because she's already almost due. When you get to your third trimester, you can have a DNA test. It doesn't have to be when the child is born, though that's the one that people wait for. But why is he not willing to go for DNA test? I mean, you know, Nigerians, we talk about things and we talk about if you are not sure that a child is yours, go on. This is what is happening all over the world now. DNA has become, you know, what people do when they are not sure. Go for a DNA test. From what we are hearing, from things that happen in Africa now, for even the judge that just found out his children are not his, of course we should encourage DNA tests. If any man has any doubt, one atom of doubt, go for DNA test. I was telling my husband the other day, if you want to go for DNA test with my son, go ahead. Women should not be afraid unless we are saying we're doing the wrong thing. If you know you have not stepped with any other person, it is only your husband, why will you be afraid of DNA tests? But this time, it's not even the woman, no, it's the man who doesn't want to go for the DNA test. And that got me wondering, why doesn't he want to go for the DNA test? What is keeping him from going for the DNA test? Okay? And, you know, people stay in Nigeria, they have their own judgment, they talk about things. I think he's responsible, but you know, she obviously cheated. How do you know she cheated? We don't know. I mean, this story just, you know, it just came on people's trend and is trending. And I'm like, let me see what somebody just said. Somebody said, this man, let me see what he said. Hold on. Somebody just said something. Let's see what the person said. This man may not have the money to go for DNA test. Well, it's not that expensive. DNA test is not that expensive. Let's get a point. You know, when we hear about DNA test, is that we don't live in Nigeria. They don't live in Nigeria. This is the Western world. And anyway, there are ways to pay for things in the Western world. We know that you can spread payment for most of the things. DNA tests can be done with, even, let me tell you, if this woman makes as a case, the doctor would do it for them. We're not in Nigeria. These people are not in Nigeria. But we don't know their story anyway. But from the way the guy is, sounding, I'm kind of like wondering, why is he not willing to go for the DNA test? Why is he not willing to go for it? I mean, he should be willing to go for the DNA test, to be frank. He should be, yeah? And whoever that is making, you know what, social media, I'm going to tell you, yeah, sometimes social media, the phones, it has made our life not private anymore. Why did they even bring that case outside? I mean, people just passing on the road, they are taking videos, they are recording your life, and it goes trending. This video now is trending. This woman has gone viral, and people are talking about it. This is a private life for crying out loud. People have done worse things, okay? So what if after this woman, after she's given birth, they find out that it is the man's child, or what if it's not the man's child, but their news has gone viral? Their village people have, they know the story now. That, what if this woman did not even tell the parents that she was pregnant? Now they know. Because some people don't even bother telling them. Now they know. It has gone viral, okay? I mean, oh my God, you know what, social media is becoming crazy. But I'm going to end, you know, I love ending. Some people said the boy is doing well now and she wants to hold him down. Okay, I don't know. But if a guy could live with you and stay with you and he went for a walk, what do you mean by hold him down? They've been living together, so they had a relationship. So what do you mean by hold him down? So what if it's her prayer that God has answered? Let's stop all these hold people down. This is Europe now we're talking about. If this man has her paper, what is holding down? She's not in Nigeria. She's not poor. The system will take care of her. So we know we reason and we talk because we live in Nigeria. See, in Europe, everybody can aspire to be anything. Whether you're a man or a woman, you can aspire to be anything. All you have to do is just have an ambition. Just have an ambition and you get to anywhere you want to get to. Okay? Who fuck am I? Be no fuck. I don't know. I don't know whether the guy no fuck. I love the friend. We need this kind of friends in our life. Friends that are willing to fight for us. Friends that are willing to stand up for us. Friends that are willing to even, like, you know, pick that our husband that are messing up for us. We need such friends. Okay? See how she was fighting and fighting. Even when they say they are calling police, the woman did not care. She was saying, you know, do what? You know, do what? It's a funny story. It's a funny video because Nigerians are laughing about it and it's going viral. But I want to say something. In this day and age of DNA, everything is going DNA, DNA, DNA. We need to understand that if a man wants the DNA, give it to him. Give it to him. Unless you have something to hide, give him the DNA. Let him go ahead and do it. Because for us, you know, Nigerians, anything that comes up and becomes a craze, it becomes a craze. So for the next how many years now, DNA is what we're going to be hearing, okay? And for this couple, for the sake of the child, a child doesn't need this environment. What a child needs is love. You guys should just put away all this problem, wait for this child to be born, then you go for DNA. Since the guy is not sure, I don't blame him for not being sure. If his friends are saying the woman is sleeping around, there is a trouser that is not his trouser in the house. Oh my God, I don't blame him. And he's been away for 9 months and you come back and the woman says she's, I don't blame him because the timing doesn't, it doesn't tally. Okay. So my advice to you, I like ending with advice. If you live in the Western world, please don't get pregnant without actually talking it through with a man. You just don't get pregnant unless you are willing to do it without him, which you can. If you're getting too old and you want to have your own baby, it's not a crime. Have your baby. You need someone to look after you. But if you decide to have that baby and you did not tell the man and the man is not aware, then don't put it on him. Though we all know that in the Western world, the man will still pay for childcare. He will still pay for childcare. All these things he's talking about, calling the police and everything, it doesn't stop the fact that if that child belongs to him, if the DNA is done, this man will still pay for childcare. Yes, he will. You put the sperm in, so you're going to pay for childcare, whether you like it or not. Okay? And he said, I will blow you. Let me tell you, there are things we don't do in Western world. Touch a pregnant woman, you're going to jail for that. Some Nigerian, you know, African men, they think they're in Nigeria. The way they talk or the way, even threatening her while she was pregnant. And she called, the police are called. And this video is an evidence. We think we're in Africa. We still carry that, our African mentality, to Europe. That's how he will now fuck up his life. I'm telling you. Anyway, guys, this video is kind of like, it talks about, this is real. It's happening in the Western world. People get pregnant. People, you know, try to hustle. People want to live together. You don't want to pay the full house rent. You are not married. Somebody's calling you my wife. Get sense. Get sense. That's all I'm saying. And if you decide to get pregnant, make sure that if the guy, you are willing to go it on your own. If the guy says he's not going to do it, because if he's not aware, he's going to deny you. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching. What do you guys think about this story? What do you guys think the guy should do? For me, I believe that he should wait for when the child is born or go and do DNA, because he doesn't believe, but this relationship is broken. For him ever denying, that means for him even doubting, is not a strong relationship. I don't know how they're going to mend it. That's my take on this story. I'll see you guys tomorrow when I bring another story your way. Trending news, hot news your way. And please, please, please subscribe to my channel, my YouTube channel, Life Issues. Please, please, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.